So, while it's good that our model can nicely describe the prices of the vintages that have been used to estimate our model, which is called an in-sample fit, the much more important criterion whether this is a good model that Eschenfelder have developed is basically it out of sample prediction accuracy. How well can it describe the future auction prices of vintages that they have not looked at when they developed their model? So kind of for future years. And only if the model can basically is helpful also for new observation, then it's really a useful model for your investment decision. And in the sense, because I mean, if you would have a very complex model, for example, you will see that you can always very nicely describe the data you have used for estimating the model. But it may be very bad out of sample for a new data set because you have a problem of overfitting. And modern machine learning approaches to prediction problems kind of have nicely formalized this assessment of out of sample prediction accuracy. Basically, before you estimate a model, you will split it into a test data set and a remaining training data set, and first develop your whole model only on the training data set, and only in the very end look at the test data set to assess the prediction accuracy. Now, we haven't done this here, and it's also too late to do it because, I mean, I mean, we could in principle say we only use 20 of the 28. I think we have around 28 data points for the estimation. We may only use 20 and use the remaining 8 to assess prediction accuracy. But there have already been made a lot of decisions. For example, the functional form that we use the log level regression. We have already looked at the whole data set and basically determined that this is a nice functional form. Also, probably Eschenfelder, when they thought which variables they wanted to include in their regression, they looked which gave a very nice fit. So basically, we cannot now just split the data set into a smaller training data set we use for estimation, a test data set to get the out of sample prediction, as we will later do in the machine learning approach. Here, what we actually would want to do, we want to use newer vintages whose auction prices were not known at the time Eschenfelder developed their model. So at least from 1980 onwards, or maybe even later years, and look how well the model of Eschenfelder works there. So we would need to collect the weather data and the basically compute the price index and compare then the actual price index with the price index we would predict from the model. So actually, the data set by Eschenfelder, if we look at it, the original data set, it contains weather variables from the year 1981 to 1988, which have not been used for the estimation and hopefully also not for basically building the model formula, for example, determining that you want to logarithm the price. Because for this data, we don't have any auction prices available. Now, the first question is, do you think, can we use this data set, even so we don't have any auction prices available, to make a prediction of the auction price? Or can we only make predictions for data set where we have the price available?